Hey friends, we all know Azure Functions enables you to run code on demand without having to explicitly provision or manage infrastructure. But get this, now you can use Azure Functions to automate all your cloud and on-premises tasks using PowerShell. Eamon O'Reilly is here to show me how today on Azure Friday. Hey folks, I'm Scott Hanselman and it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Eamon O'Reilly to talk about one of my favorite things, Azure Functions, plus one of my other favorite things, PowerShell.
Awesome.
Thanks, Scott. It's happening.
It is. It's all happening.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
So this is PowerShell Core.
Yep. PowerShell Core, PowerShell 6 inside of Functions. Mm-hmm. Basically, what we've heard a lot over the, you know, customers using Functions for all the kind of event-based application development, we've also seen them, hey, how can I use this for my event-based cloud automation? And so one of the primary languages to do that is PowerShell. So we said, let's add PowerShell into Functions so that now they get all the benefits of the Functions, serverless, event-based, but now they use PowerShell to do it.
Mm-hmm. And this is PowerShell Core, which is open source and powered by .NET Core.
Correct. Powered by .NET Core, all open source, and we even use the latest AZ modules for Azure Management.
Seriously. So this is great. Now, would I want to write a whole website in this, or is this primarily for administrative things?
Generally for administrative things. You know, that's really what it's good for, gluing, sticking things together, giving you the ability to operationalize all of your applications and your infrastructure at the same time.
Fantastic. Let's see it.
Yeah, so inside the portal, you can see here that I have a function. And if I go to create a new one, I'll show you the experience. We've added PowerShell as an option now. Mm-hmm. So you'll be able to do all the same things you could have if you were selecting another application. So I can basically say I'll do it inside the portal. And I'll just do a simple webhook one for now.
Okay.
So generally, these will be used if you're triggering them from some external application that says, you know, go ahead and provision a bunch of my machines or add a new database. So here you can see now it's all PowerShell natively in the browser based on PowerShell 6 core. And I can go ahead and just run this without making any changes. And I'll get that same great experience you can see down here where it just runs. And the output comes across as Hello Azure. So I can modify the input. I can do all my development testing just like I would normally if I was developing locally inside the browser as well, all running PowerShell based on PowerShell Core.
Now, when folks are doing PowerShell, they kind of expect to move fast. You know, we think about what's called the developer's inner loop.
Yes.
Right. Make a change and check it. Make a change and check it.
Yeah.
Can I do that with PowerShell and Azure?
Yeah,
Functions?
I mean, that's the real benefit. And we've actually done a few extra features inside of Functions to make it even easier to use PowerShell than you normally would. Mm. A couple of those I can show you. So one of the first things we've done is we already had support for managed identity inside of function apps.
Right.
So this allows you to get an identity. But if you grant that identity access to your Azure resources, like your Azure subscription, now, with PowerShell, we can use that to go manage all of your systems from inside the function app automatically. And so we've made a few changes so where that becomes very simple for you by basically using the identity built into PowerShell. I can show you what that looks like.
Let's do it.
Yeah, so if I go into here and I look at the console, you can actually see that there's a couple of extra files that we have inside of an app. So the first thing I'll show you is that profile. So if I just type the profile.
It's so amazing that you're inside of an Azure function and you're now at a command line and you're looking at a profile that PS1.
I know, it's pretty powerful.
But it feels very PowerShell-y.
Yes, it does. And you can basically do all the same kind of stuff you would normally do. So this is that profile. So every time your function app starts up, we actually can run this profile for you now. And one of the first things it does is if you have identity enabled, we will actually automatically authenticate you. So you don't have to do it in every single script you write now.
Because you're a custom PowerShell host.
We are. So we have all this ability built in now.
That's so cool.
Yeah, so if you have some other common tasks, you can actually add them into this profile and they'll get run each time your function app starts up.
Oh, that's awesome. Now, is it each time it runs or each time it starts up? How's that scoping relationship?
So basically, as you know, a function app basically is like a host where you can have multiple functions in there.
Right.
So when the actual app starts up, we will start it. And then if you add more functions, they'll inherit the identity automatically. It only does it the first time it starts.
That's nice and
clean. So it's something you can apply across all the functions you might be writing for that function app. Like identity is a common one, but it could be some other things you need to do. Mm-hmm. A couple of other things I'll show you that we've done to make it easier. If I type the host file, so we've added a new property called managed dependency in here. And so what this is, it allows you basically to tell the function service that I want you to manage all of my dependencies for me. Mm-hmm. And the idea behind this is, you know, with serverless, we're trying to basically abstract away all the complexity in managing the infrastructure from the OS to the runtime, like the .NET runtime. We're now giving the ability to also abstract away managing your modules and other dependencies you have from third party by automatically updating those for you. So by setting this to true, what happens when it the server starts up, it's going to look in this requirements file. And so inside of here, you can see I've said I want the AZ modules, and I want 1.asterisk. So basically, as new AZ modules come out, I want the server to take care of integrating those and installing them automatically for me. Mm-hmm. And the real benefit you get from that is every time there's a security update or a critical update, typically you're always in what state is my function app in? Like, is am I compliant? Am I missing some security? Do I have to go and do some analysis on it? Mm-hmm. You can abstract all that away and say, servers, you go take care of it, and you automatically update it for me.
So can I say, you said 1.star, where that's minor, could I go 1.o.star and do it based on revision?
Yeah, so in public preview, we're limiting the 1.star, and then we're going to extend from there, so you get all the full flexibility that
Excellent.
You would normally have.
Because I want it to be serverless, but I also don't want it to break if someone made a breaking
That's
change.
That's right. So you can hard fix it to a specific version, or you can say, no, I trust certain vendors, and I just want to get their critical and security updates installed.
That's smart.
And so it just gives you that kind of control, but also the flexibility, like I'll do what I need to do to make the service work.
Fantastic.
So these are just kind of built in automatically, and you can take advantage of them as you want to by just turning them on and off, and then you can keep adding from there.
Well, you're doing a lot of this inside of the browser here, but sometimes I hear people talking about doing Azure Functions on an airplane, or they talk about how great the Azure Functions runtime is.
Yep.
I assume I have flexibility.
You have. So you can basically do all of this either inside the browser or completely locally using VS Code and all of the local runtime that we offer. So let me actually show you a little bit of an experience of that. But before I jump in there, I wanted to show you kind of a larger flow as well.
Okay.
It doesn't really do anything too special.
You can close that one there on the left right there.
Oh, yeah, it'll open up a little bit for me.
There you go.
Thanks. Yeah, so this is basically one that integrates in with EventGrid.
Okay.
So what this does is every time a database gets created,
right,
I want to get a notification from EventGrid to call my function, and then I'm going to, with that function, see if it's the last database in the SQL server, and if it is, I'm going to send a Teams notification to myself.
Ooh.
And so all of this done and with like, you know, 20 lines of PowerShell, yeah, which is that glue you're talking about. It's so easy to connect all these systems together.
Yeah.
Within about, you know, it took me about maybe 20 minutes,
yep,
and I had this script running. And I can basically now, if I went into one of my databases,
yep,
let me just go to one here if I can. I can see I created a
little SQL server there.
Yeah, there's a SQL server, and here's a database. So I'll just go in and delete it.
Okay, so we got a little SQL database here.
Yep. And I'm just going to delete this guy. So he's called what, Friday PowerShell, and he's gone. So now, because I've hooked up an event grid subscription to that, you can see here that every time now that notification is going to call my function.
Mm.
And so this is the nice thing about this event-based automation model is that you can start to say, when these events happen across Azure, the ones I care about, call me, and then I'm going to process those and do something on them.
Certainly, if someone deletes my database in production, I'd like to hear more than just a Teams notification.
That's maybe right. Can, you might want some alarms to go off.
We could even automatically fire that person.
Exactly. So one thing you mentioned about the local experience as well.
Yep.
So if I went into VS Code, so the advantage we have here is that, you know, we have this function extension that's available already inside of the Azure extension.
Yep.
So I can go in here and click on Create. And I'll just pick that Azure Friday. It seems PowerShell now is an option.
Nice.
So I can pick PowerShell as my language. I can pick all the different templates. So as you know, there's lots of triggers available. All of those triggers are available for PowerShell as well. So I could say, you know, if somebody drops something in a queue, I want to go process it with PowerShell.
Nice.
If it's on a timer trigger or using HTTP.
So PowerShell is first class.
First class across the entire environment. So everything you could do with C# or Java or Python, you could do now with PowerShell as well. Very seamlessly, you just pick whatever you want, and it will go and create that for you. So just like that, you'll end up with, just like you did in the cloud,
yep,
but now it's all local. And the real benefit of this is now you get all of the IntelliSense, everything you'd want to do with PowerShell locally, plus you get local debugging, which is really what Functions gives you that power of it.
And does that work on Mac and Linux too? Because PowerShell Core is
It does. Cross. That's the real nice about it. You can have your Mac running here, you can have your Linux environment running, it'll work exactly the same way. Then you just debug, get it working, publish it in, and now you have all these automation just running automatically in the cloud.
Fantastic.
Yep, and so you can even see I just got an alert down here in Teams.
Yep.
So if I go into Teams, you can see I just got a notification.
Ooh, nice clean alert. It's an alert that actually has a little card and everything.
It has. So you can see I just deleted Friday PowerShell. And if I click in here, because I've set up the links, it'll bring me back into that SQL Server inside my Azure environment, and I can see, was this the last database? What do I want to go do with this?
See, now you've got me thinking about all the stuff I could potentially automate with functions in PowerShell.
It does. It really makes it easy to glue these things together and start to kind of automate all your processes.
Well, you're normally doing. We need to make sure that all the PowerShell people out there that are running scripts while true,
yep,
need to know about this event-based way of doing things with PowerShell.
It is. It's like a new kind of way of thinking about doing work, just like functions was. But once you get into it, it really becomes powerful, and you can start to build from there.
Absolutely. This is moving beyond cron jobs into something more.
That's really what it is. It's kind of all about events now, and how do I actually react to those in real time.
So this is in preview, but coming soon. I can play with it now, and I can put it in production soon?
That's right. So over the next few months, it'll go into general availability. But we'd really like some feedback during public preview. Make sure it's working well for you. It's open source, so you can get feedback directly on GitHub, or you can ask questions on our forums, and we'll love to get the feedback.
Absolutely brilliant. I am learning all about Azure PowerShell inside Azure Functions today on Azure Friday.